Benefits versus risk approach to regulating therapeutic goods. Information for consumers. The benefits and risks of medicines and medical devices. Medicines and medical devices are used when you are sick or to prevent illness. To be effective, they must modify the way the body works. This means there are risks as well as benefits associated with their use. Because of the risks, these products are regulated. The TGA assesses medicines and medical devices according to what type of product they are and their associated level of risk. Therapeutic goods cannot lawfully be supplied in Australia unless they have been authorised by the TGA or are exempt. The potential benefits of an individual product will determine what risks we are prepared to accept before authorising the product for supply. The TGA's role is to ensure that, on balance, the benefits outweigh any known risks. To do this, we have to know what the benefits and risks are. How do we know about the benefits and risks of medicines? Before a product is made available to the public, benefits can be determined through laboratory studies and clinical trials. These scientific studies look at, for example, chemistry, pharmacology, toxicity, physiology, biochemistry, anatomy, epidemiology, immunology, and genetics. Some products are used by millions of people. When authorising a medicine, we take into account the overall risk and benefit to the entire population. There is huge diversity across the population, so it's not possible to consider the risk a medicine or medical device may pose to every individual patient. What do we do for higher risk medicines? We look at extensive clinical trials in healthy and sick volunteers. We also look at pharmacodynamics, or how the medicine works in the body, pharmacokinetics, or how the body metabolises the medicine, and toxicity. What else do we do for higher risk medicines? We also look at pharmaceutical chemistry, shelf life, and risk factors. What do we do for lower risk medicines? We ensure they only contain permitted ingredients, those we already know are lower risk. The TGA requires companies to hold the necessary evidence to support the claims being made, including the therapeutic claims. How do we know about the benefits and risks of medical devices? We check there are no unacceptable risks for medical devices, including software design and engineering. We look at all the information to determine if the benefits outweigh the risks. What's the difference between higher and lower risk medical devices? To make decisions about the level of risk, we look at the intended use of the device, the risk to patients, the degree of invasiveness in the body, and the duration of use. Medical devices can't be tested like medicines in traditional clinical trials. Most devices are improvements of older versions based on data collected from real-life use. For both higher-risk and lower-risk products, we require that they are manufactured in accordance with internationally agreed standards. To be approved, the benefits of a medicine or medical device must outweigh the known risks for the intended purpose. Our work is ongoing. We regulate medicines and medical devices for as long as they are being used. We're always on the lookout for potential problems. Once a product is authorised, it can be used in the general population. This means it may be used in situations where the TGA has not assessed the risks and benefits. These situations can lead to unknown problems that were not identified in the evaluation process. This is why it is important that you report problems to us. you can help improve public health and safety. If you experience an unexpected side effect from a therapeutic good, first seek advice from a health professional. Then contact us to tell us what happened. You can also ask your health professional to do this for you. These reports help us monitor therapeutic goods, and we use this information as one of the triggers for taking action. What happens when you tell us about a problem? We assess the new evidence and decide if any action needs to be taken. This may include issuing new safety advice and information, monitoring the product over time to identify any further issues, recalling the product, or restricting access. What happens if the rules are broken? If a sponsor breaks the conditions of the authorisation, the therapeutic good could be cancelled or suspended. It is important that suppliers know what is legal and illegal. We provide information and educational activities to assist them. You can find out more by visiting www.tga.gov.au or calling 1800 020 653.